Hello students, welcome to the session. I am Mr. M.H. Mota, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering. And this session is on water conveyance. Let's see the outcome of these sessions. This session will be helpful for you to understand and explain the methods of water conveyance for water treatment plant. You will learn how the water can be conveyed to the water treatment plant. And along with this, you will be able to summarize the characteristics of CI pipes which are dominantly used as a mean of water conveyance to the water treatment plant. Let's learn it in more detail. So, water conveyance. Water is conveyed or transported from the source to the treatment plant and after treatment from this treatment plant to community through various types of conduits. They may be open or closed types. Open type means the conveyance system or the water in it is open to an ambient atmosphere. While in closed type system, the water is enclosed, like in case of pipe. The various types of conduits used are open channels, tunnels, and pipelines. Open channels are the channels made specially for the conveyance of water. Generally, we don't use such thing for conveying water up to the water treatment plant. But such systems are much more helpful to convey the water with ease from a source like river to a place where no perennial or other source is available. In such cases, the open channel is much more helpful to convey the water from, say, a river to a small town, from where it can be lifted and then afterwards it can be treated. Pipelines are invariably used for conveyance of water because of their closeness and in line the reduced risk of pollution. The losses in conveyance of water are also very less in case of pipelines. So the pipelines. Pipelines are usually follow the profile of the ground. They are generally run as the ground runs. Unlike the in case of channels or tunnels where we generally expect the continuous falling gradient so that the water can run under the effect of gravity. But in case of pipelines, we can have a certain profile which runs along with the ground. They can be either rising or falling in few cases too, or vice versa. The pipelines used are important transportation system for conveying such water. For making a complete system along with pipes, we need different types of walls like gate walls, check walls, release walls, different types of drains, the surge control equipments, the manholes and pumping stations. Water may flow under gravity or under pressure. Generally, in case of pipelines, where the water runs from, or rather lifted from the source to the water treatment plant and from water treatment plant to the different consumer, it runs always under a pressure. The pressure can be generated in case of rising main with the help of pump, while the same pressure can be generated with the help of falling gradient, where water runs generally under gravity in case of distribution system. Now let's try to understand the different types of piping materials available. So they are cast iron, wrought iron, steel, galvanized iron, cement concrete pipes, asbestos cement pipes, copper pipes, lead pipes, PVC pipes, etc. Out of this, in case of conveyance of water from a source to the water treatment plant and from water treatment plant to individual customer, generally the cast iron is a type of material which is dominantly used. In this session, we will try to understand these cast iron or CI pipes in detail. So CI pipes are used in great majority of water distribution mains because of its satisfactory experience. The life of such pipe is very high. The experience tells us that such kind of pipes can be lasted up to 100 years or even more. In case of cast iron pipe, it resists the corrosion. They are manufactured by two methods, ordinary sand molding process or centrifugal process. In case of sand casting, the molten metal is poured into sand-lined molds that are set in either a vertical or horizontal position. Horizontally casted pipes are referred as McVen pipes, while those casted in vertical positions are referred as pit cast. In centrifugal process, pipes may be cast either in a sand mold or in a water-cooled metal mold. The former is known as sand spun pipe, while the latter is called Devlin pipe. Centrifugal process produces a fine-grained and denser structure with a more uniform thickness. Hence, these pipes are denser and lighter. Such pipes are generally manufactured in the length of 3 to 6 meter. The connections are made either spigot and socket joint or flange joints. So this figure shows the spigot and socket joint. The enlarged end of a pipe is known as socket or sometimes called as a bell. The socket accommodates the normal or the spigot end. The hemp or sterilized yarn is used to maintain the alignment, and molten lead heated around 400 degrees Celsius is then poured, and then it is used to cast this joint. The quantity of lead varies from about 5 kg for 15 cm pipe to about 55 kg for the larger diameter pipes, say around 1.2 meter in diameter. These joints are also known as run lead joints. Second is the flange joints. The figure shows the flange joints, where the pipes generally used to have the flanged ends. These flanged ends can be either welded or bolted as per the need. The advantages of CI pipe. The major advantage is that they are moderate in cost. Its connections are much more easier. It offers a very high resistance to the corrosion and has got a very long life. While the limitations of CI pipe includes that it is subjected to tuberculation. Tuberculation is nothing but the deposition of the alkaline material on the inner surface of the pipe, which may, in the long run, can disturb and destroy this face. Where the thickness can be then reduced, the metal amount can be lost. Heavier and economical in case of high diameter because of its weight. It cannot be used for very high pressure like 7 kg per centimeter square or more. And the major disadvantage is that they are fragile in nature. The classes of CI pipes. The CI pipes are generally categorized with the help of their ends, whether they have socket and spigot end or flanged ends. Such pipes are then subdivided into class A and class B. This particular table represents the different diameters and the test pressures to which such pipes should able to sustain. Say for up to 300 mm diameter, the class A should able to sustain a pressure of 20 kg per centimeter square in case of socket and spigot pipes, while for class B the test pressure is 25 kg per centimeter square. And accordingly, the range of different diameter and the test pressures or the possible pressure for which it should sustain has been given. It is quite clear with the help of this table is that as diameter increases, the test pressure generally get decreased. The second part of the table provides the hydrostatic test pressure for the centrifugally cast pipes. Now, the major limitation of any sort of pipe is corrosion. So the corrosion is nothing but the effect of different things on the piping material, in which it loses its metal and in long run loses its strength and getting destroyed. The different reasons for the corrosion includes the pH of flowing water. Generally, if pH is less, then it is corrosive. So low pH always accelerate the corrosion, while high pH or alkaline water generally results in the tuberculation. So the pH of water should be around neutral. Second is the presence of water in surrounding soil and its pH. While pipe used for flowing water or the carrying water along with inside, it even can be attacked by the presence of water from outside. That water can be present in surrounding soil if the pipe is buried under the ground. Third is composition of pipe material. Fourth is temperature. Fifth is oxygen. High amount of oxygen always accelerates the process of corrosion. And last is the presence of soil bacteria. We can prevent or limit the corrosion with the help of these four methods. The first is cathodic protection. Second is the proper selection of material. We even can provide the protective lining and coating for the pipe. And last, if its pH is not in a certain range, we can offer the treatment of water. So that's it for this session. Let's meet in next session to learn more about the conveyance of water. So thank you for having me, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.